Hi, I'm Vignesh. I've been building several sensor-based projects since starting college, and I found myself particularly drawn towards building medical devices. This led me to reach out to several doctors to learn about potential problems I could solve. And in one such medical event, I actually met a doctor called Dr. Sunita. She gave us insight about the condition of neonatal healthcare in rural areas. Preterm birth complications is one of the leading causes of death in children under 5 globally, with most of these deaths occurring in developing nations. Due to lack of access to proper incubators, many primary healthcare centers are forced to use rudimentary and dangerous methods like use of incandescent bulb to provide warmth to the child. Not only is this quite dangerous in that it causes burns, it's also extremely inefficient. We want to try and solve that. We found two solutions that try to address access to incubation in rural areas. First was the GE lullaby system, which despite having diagnostic capabilities and being reliable, it was still expensive and stationary in nature. In the other end of the spectrum, there was the embrace system, which despite being low cost and passive, it lacked diagnostic capabilities that could detect any emergencies the child had, like hypoxemia or apnea. We want to bridge that by making a system which possesses diagnostic capabilities while also being low cost in nature.
The parameters aim to monitor our respiration rate, ECG, blood oxygenation, and the body temperature.
Respiration is monitored using a piezo-resistive fabric belt whose resistance changes according to the chest expansion and relaxation. The blood oxygen is a vital parameter to detect hypoxia or low blood oxygenation. A MAX30100 sensor is used with a custom 3D printed ear clip for monitoring. The ECG is monitored using a custom conductive fabric-based belt, which helps prevent skin allergy caused by the gel-type electrodes. The ECG is acquired by the ADS1292-based system. The heating element used is based on the latex fabric. The CSD18504N MOSFET is used for controlling the heating element, controlled through PWM and PID. The CC3200 Wi-Fi microcontroller is the central element of our system. It sends the vital parameters over a Wi-Fi gateway to the doctor. Alerts can be configured to detect the emergencies in the child's health. The body temperature is measured in the armpit using the LMT70. The connector used is also based on conductive textile to increase the comfort. This is used to control the heating element using PID control. We are using lithium iron phosphate battery for its safety and reliability over lithium polymers once switched into export. The TPS55340 boost converter module is used to step up to 9V for the heating element.
We designed ADITI with comfort, functionality and cost in mind. Mostly off-the-shelf components were used to reduce cost. Here is the bill of materials used in our project.
Now over to our assessment. To implement a sustainable wearable, we are primarily aiming to get this product validated by some of the medical professionals. We are also taking into account the parent sentiments and implementing as suggested by the IM mentors. We showed this product to some of the doctors and the feedback was pretty amazing. Once this product gets validated, we are looking to work with groups like UNICEF and Doctors Without Borders to extend neonatal care.
I'm Dr. Sunita. Infant mortality rate is very high in India, especially in the rural areas, due to the less availability of medical facilities and incubators. And incandescent practices are followed. A modified device like ADITI will help to reduce the infant mortality, especially in rural areas.